Hi, this is JB from Northerlights over Arkham. This time I will be continuing System Ares' run through the Return to Dunwich Legacy campaign. We are at the Essex County Express, and last time we didn't earn any more experience in the Miskatonic Museum, so let's check the deck quickly before we start. I didn't make any changes to the deck with the 1 XP I still have over from the previous scenarios, so no changes were made to the deck. There are, however, some changes to the Chaos pack, so we had to add 1 tablet token to the bag. And also at the start of the this scenario we add a -3, and the 2 less tokens that System Mary adds. So we are playing the Return to version of the Essex County Express. I think this is one of the harder scenarios as a solo player, but in the normal version, but in the Return to version it's really hard, so let's see how System Mary does. So let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so let's draw the opening hand. We get the Winchester, we get Olive, and a bunch of other cards, so I think I will be just setting up. So we might as well try to mulligan these to maybe get some way to get some more resources, so I'm mulligan these 3. And of course we need a way to investigate, so okay, we got the 6 cents. 2 scene of the crimes. Oh, okay. I think I'm playing the scene of the crime right away. These scene of the crimes are actually really good in this scenario, because we can't move towards without investigating. So it may well be that we are just playing scene of the crime as a first action, moving on, and maybe playing Olive or the Sixth Sense and not worry about fighting. Although if we don't have anything for fighting, that may be a problem later. Okay, so let's think. The sure thing is to play the scene of the crime, so we spend 2. We get the clue of this location. Second action, I think I'll get a resource. And last action, I'll play the Winchester. This is just in case if we hit an enemy early. We have some way to deal with the enemy, even if it's not optimal with the without Olive in play right at the start. So that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We gain a resource and at the end of the round, we add 1 plus token to the back. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. The threshold is only 2. The encounter card is Mysterious Chanting. So, we search for a cultist because there are no cultists in play. I think I'm just searching for an acolyte. Oh yeah, this goes into the discard, and we shuffle the encounter deck. And I think we'll put the cultist to the next train car, so we can get rid of him right away. And the cultist has 1 doom on it. That's the mythos phase. We'll go to the investigation phase. First action, we'll just move to this train car. So it's the sleeping car. It's a 4 shard location with 1 clue. A sleeping car is connected to the location to the left and right. Action gained 3 resources. Remember that you have stolen a passenger's luggage. Group limit once per game. So I think we are scene of the crime next turn, and we'll definitely grab the luggage. Second action, we'll use the Winchester to shoot. We really don't need to hit with this shot. We need to hit, but we don't need to hit the positive, non-negative token. So let's see what we get. And we get an Elder sign, so we add one Bless token to the bag. This guy is dead. And last action, we'll gain three resources and remember that we went through the luggage. That is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get another deny existence. And we gain one resource. And we add a bless token to the back. So we have five bless tokens in the back. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so the agenda advances. And this is the where there is smoke. Agenda 0A. So we get the conductor, beast from beyond the gates. It's a monster elite. It has 3 fight, 4 health, and 3 evade. Spawn leftmost location. Hunter massive force when the conductor is defeated. Attach it to the current agenda. After you advance the attached agenda, draw the conductor. Force when the conductor's location leaves play, instead of discarding the conductor, move it to the locate one location to the right. Okay, so we get the conductor here. Then we have the agenda 1A there. In reality, it has a doom threshold. Encounter card for this turn is, it's another acolyte. So I think we are killing this acolyte too, just by going to the next car. But first we need to get rid of this clue here. So first action, I am playing another scene of the crime. So we grab clue. Second action, I'll move to this train car. So, it's the dining car. It's a two-shroud location with zero clues. Dining car is connected to the locations left and right. Forced after you reveal dining car, search the encounter deck and discard pile for a grappling horror and draw it. Okay, so that may be a problem. So the grappling horror is, it's, let's see, okay, so the grappling horror is a 3 fight, 3 health and 2 evade monster abomination. It has the hunter. When you are engaged with the grappling horror, you cannot move, so it comes into play and is engaged with us. This cultist is also engaged with us. So I think the first thing we do is to let's just kill the cultist. We have to deal with this grappling horror next turn. So last action, we'll just shoot the cultist. Shooting 5 versus 3. And it's a -4, so we unfortunately miss. Enemy phase, the conductor moves here. These guys hit, so I'll take 2 damage. 1 horror. and we go to upkeep, so we ready up, we draw a card, we get prepared for the worst, and we gain one resource. So, that is that turn. We'll add another bless token into the bag. So we have 6 bless tokens there. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. This turn we really need to kill the grappling horror, and then we just have to move because otherwise the conductor will just be on us. So, oh yeah, and this is advancing. So this goes away. So keep moving. Remove the leftmost location from the game, or place it in the victory display if it has victory X and no clues on it. Each investigator at the location is defeated. Each enemy and asset at that location is discarded. Discard all clues controlled by the investigators. So these are removed, and this is removed. And that is that. Then we have agenda 2A, the more widens. 3 Doom Threshold encounter card for this turn is Idle Hands. So if Idle Hands is in your threat area during your turn, take 2 damage and discard Idle Hands. You may take an additional action this turn. At the end of the turn, take 1 horror. So I think the horror is fine. First action. I really need to kill the grappling horror, so I'm shooting that. And there's basically nothing to commit to this test, so, well, I'll commit the prepared for the worst. Okay, so we hit the bless token, so now we just need to hit. And it's a minus one, so we managed to hit and kill this grappling horror. Then we have to move. We'll move to the next train car, and it's the baggage car. Oh, great. So the baggage car is connected to the locations to the left and right to it. The baggage car cannot be investigated. Action, choose and discard a card from your hand. Discard for 1 clue in the baggage car. Okay, so we'll move, we'll take 1 damage, and there's 3 clues here. So we need to, for our last action, we'll need to, I'll deny existence and take 1 attack of opportunity to discover 1 clue. Next turn we need to defeat this. Well, let's see what we do next turn. Okay, I think that is our investigation phase. Enemy phase, the conductor moves here. This acolyte hits us, we'll deny the damage. We go to upkeep, we draw David Renfield and again 1 resource. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add 1 bless token to the bag. We add a doom to the agenda. The encounter card is... Oh yeah, and we had the idle hand, so we took 1 horror, which is fine, and we get another idle hands. So, again, now we take 2 horror at the end of the round, so not looking good. First action. I just have to kill this cultist. There's no way around it. I think we're dead. We can't. Let's math it out now. So I think this is the last turn in any way. Or the only possibility is to move there, kill this, move there, evade, and that's it. And that is the only way we survive, so I think that is the play. So we're shooting 5 versus 3 using the Winchester. It's a plus one, so this is dead. Second action. We have to move back here. So this is massive, so we just try to evade it. We don't have anything to commit. Or let's go back. second action, I'll play Olive and last action I'll play David Renfield. I'll place one Doom on it and exhaust and gain one resource. Okay, and we have six cents in hand. So the plan here is that now the conductor moves in, kills off David. That's fine. Next turn we can evade using Olive and maybe get these clues and then again evade. Well, it's a slow process, but we'll see how it goes. I think we're still screwed. So this conductor moves in, hits us, killing David. Oh yeah, and we took two horror from these idle hands. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get evidence, and we gain one resource. Evidence, not that useful here. Okay, we add a bless token into the bag. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a Doom. The encounter card is Haunting Recollections. For each card in your hand, if there is a copy of that card in your discard pile, take one horror. If you take no horror, discard the top three cards in your deck. We don't have any copies of these two cards, so we discard three cards. And we lose Second Wind, the Tower, and Ward of Protection. So at least we discarded one weakness. First action, we are trying to evade. I'm evading 3 versus 3, and I am using Olive. So we grab 3 tokens. I cancel one. We get 3 blessed, so we cancel one of the blessed. Then we see what these... Yeah, well, let's first see what these tokens are. So first one is a skull. It's a minus X. It's a minus 2 because it's agenda 2. Another bless. And it's a minus 3, so it's basically a plus 1. And the last one is a minus 1, so we are definitely keeping these. So we are plus 2, so this guy is evaded. And these all go away. Okay, so we have only 3 tokens in the bag. Then we need to... I think we should have discarded one card when we took the one clue. So I think I had the sixth sense in hand then. So I'll discard the evidence to get one clue from there. Okay, now I'm just thinking what I will do with my last action. I think I'll have to do this. So I'll... No, okay. It's just not worth it. So I think I'll just draw a card So yeah, we can take the initiative, which is really good for next turn. And that is our turn. We take two horror. I'll place them on Olive. And we ready. And we draw a card. And we gain one resource. And we place one blessed token back into the back. So there are four blessed tokens in the back. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at three doom, so we advance. So, don't stop. Remove the leftmost location from the game. Each investigator at the location is defeated. Each enemy at the and asset at the location is discarded. Discard all clues controlled by investigators. So, these are discarded. And this is removed. And that is it. Then, rolling backwards. It has four doom threshold. And encounter card is Broken Rails. Each investigator at your location loses one action. Each investigator at your location with four or more damage must also discard an asset he or she controls. Goodbye, Winchester. Oh, yeah, I don't have four or more damage. Okay, so unfortunately, we lost the action, which is really bad, but we'll still take the initiative to evade, and I'm using Olive. So we grab three tokens. Okay. So let's see how far that blessed token goes. It's a minus one, so it's basically a plus one. So it does, this is a minus two, and this is a plus two, so we are even. So we evade. So our total is three, four, five, three against three, so we just barely pass. So the conductor is evaded. Last action, we will discard a card to get this clue. And next turn, we will be able to get moving, hopefully. And no enemy phase action, so we go to upkeep. The organ is ready, so yeah, and I'll take two horror again. So I'm pretty much dying to horror soon, so we draw a card. We get Henry Armitage, which is basically a plus to our evade, and we gain one resource. And we add a bless token to the back. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, and the encounter card is Need for Knowledge. Revelation, if you have no clues, Need for Knowledge gains search. I have one. Otherwise, test X, intellect, where X is the equal the number of clues you have, to a maximum of 5. For each point you fail by, you must either take one horror or place one of your clues on your location. So I think I'm testing intellect 1 against 2, so I'm just testing it. And it's a minus 1, so I'll pass, so nothing happens. First action, we are evading. I'm committing Armitage to the test. I am using Olive. So I am testing 5 versus 3, drawing 3 tokens. Okay. I have to cancel that one. So, unfortunately, we fail. So we are at 5 against 3, so 2 up, but we are get a minus 4. Second action, we'll try to evade again without any help. 3 versus 3. We need to get really lucky. And it's a zero, so we got extremely lucky. Last action will move to the next train car, and it's the passenger car. It's a shroud of two with two clues. And forced, after you enter passage car, you must either discard cards from the from your hand with at least two total wheel icons or take two horror. So unfortunately we don't have any cards in hand, so we have to take two horror. This will put us at eight. And there's no way around it. I could take two damage to get an extra action, which won't to get rid of this and take an extra action. Or also I put one on myself and one on Olive. Then I take one horror, which will defeat me. So yeah, so I think I will die to horror, because then I at least get the mental trauma and not the physical. So yeah, unfortunately that is the end of this scenario from Sister Mary. We did pretty well, we got nearly to the end, so only two train cars left, or one train car and the engine. But yeah, at the end of our turn, we'll take two horror. So, Olive is defeated. And the last horror goes to me, and Sister Mary is defeated by horror. Okay, well, let's see the resolution. So, before resolving any other solution, if at least one investigator was defeated, the defeated investigator is the investigator defeat first. Each investigator who was defeated has acquired the across space and time weakness and must add one copy of it to his or her deck. This card does not count towards the investigator's deck size. So we get across space and time. It's a madness. A revelation, discard the top three cards of your deck. Each investigator who was defeated earns one bonus experience, as his or her experience beyond the gates grants them insight into the cosmos. So we get actually one experience, so we have two. So I think we are upgrading something for the next scenario. We don't have the Necronomicon, so yeah, so we would record the Necronomicon was stolen, but we don't add that. If an investigator with Dr. Herney Armitage card, the Professor Warren Rice card, or the Dr. Francis Morgan card in his or her deck was defeated, you can ballot record that the character in question was kidnapped. So both Dr. Francis Morgan and Dr. Henry Armitage were kidnapped, so those will be removed from my deck. If no resolution was reached, go to resolution 2. In your campaign log, record the investigators were delayed on their way to Dunwich, and each investigator earns experience equal to victory X value on each card in the victory display, which is zero. So we got one experience. We lost both Henry Armitage and Dr. Francis Morgan, which is a shame. And we, to top it all off, we got one mental resource, a mental trauma for Sister Mary. Yeah, so as I said at the start of this scenario, this is a tough one. Actually, in the return to version, this conductor makes it a really, really tough. You have to be able to fight right from the start, and you also have to be able to get the clues. And unfortunately, this package card is just murder if you have to first deal with a couple of enemies. And of course, in the dining car, we got the grappling horror, which slowed us down quite a bit. But yeah, I'm happy I got this far, so it wasn't a really short playthrough in the end. But next time we will be figuring out the plot on the altar and trying to rescue all the kidnapped allies. So, thanks for watching, and until next time.